Emma. I have to get her in here. How's my hat? Is that all right?
So, ladies and gentlemen, as we are starting to wrap up this evening, we've got a couple of more interviews. I would like to have you give a round of applause to the young man who's been giving us wonderful music and beautiful offerings this entire evening.
Thank you.
This is Solomon Morris.
Yeah, thank you.
I have to find out just a little bit more about you, Mr. Morris, in a moment. But right now, here on stage, we have Miss Camilla Ross. And as it's so interesting, she is the chairman of the Sedona Arts Academy, among many other things, as we're well seeing. So I met Camilla on the phone, and we have done some arts things together here, but I hadn't met her in person until just a couple of days ago.
Yeah.
So I was really thrilled and stuff, but I was also curious when she asked me to come and fulfill this role as a host slash MC, what was the impetus behind you coming into creating the Sedona Arts Academy?
You know, in Sedona, there's not a lot of space, and I live in the village, and I love the village. But we in the village needed a place to congregate, and I needed a place to do theater, to do the things that I wanted to do, and shows that, you know, maybe controversial or things of that sort, but I needed a place. And so I got the privilege to talk with Thomas McPherson, and it is because of him and that we're able to be in this space. And so I really want to give kudos to Thomas and Joanna McPherson. Because of the generous donation that they have given us, we were able to outfit this place just the way it is. So thank you, yes. Thomas and Joanna McPherson.
Thank you.
I am deeply appreciative of them because they're really community people, and we really need a lot of community here. So that's what's important is community.
So your talents and skills are in entrepreneurship? Are they in theater? Talk us through a bit more about being multifaceted Camilla.
If everybody knew what I actually did in my life, it would be interesting. So, you know, you grow up and you go to high school and you go to college. Emerson, let me give my shout out to Emersonians everywhere. And so, yes, we have one in the audience. Thanks, Denise. And so you go to college and you go to Emerson and you meet these amazing people and you begin creating. And so most
your
of my, yeah, you, well, we were creating because that's what Emerson gave us. It gave us that skill to be able to create on the fly. That's what you do. And so we did that for a while. I joined the military for a while to pay for college. And, you know, you do those things. And so I ended up one day teaching. So that's my other career. I teach accounting and finance for Three Rivers Community College on the other half of my brain. And so I'm grateful to be able to do that. But for me, it's theater. Theater is that avenue and that venue where you can just create and you can tell a story and you can tell history, and people will come out and they'll see it and they will take their own thing from it. And that's what I do best, is I create theater for a living.
And so have you been in front of the camera as an actress as well on stage?
Oh gosh, yeah, 40 years worth of stuff. And so for me, my latest role is a one-woman show called Harriet Tubman's Dream. I play Harriet Tubman. It's written by Lisa Giordano.
Wow.
She's an amazing playwright, and she's our resident playwright at Emerson Theater Collaborative. I've known her now for almost 14 years, 15 years now.
So we're going to see Harriet come to life on stage sometime this spring.
Well, no, Harriet came to life in 2017. So I did her at the Mary Fisher for the League of Women Voters.
Oh, wow. Okay.
For a half a minute. And, you know, and previous to that, I did it with the Simsbury Chorale. We took it to another level. And so we call it Harriet Squared because it's Harriet Tubman and Harriet Beecher Stowe. And we took we combined those two shows together. And instead of me singing the tunes in which Harriet sang, we had a choir sing those pieces that I would sing. And so I would freeze, and they would sing, and then I would begin when they're done. And so you can imagine what that's
like. An amazing juxtaposition.
Yes.
Amazing theatrical juxtaposition.
Absolutely. And so that is what I do.
And then to just bring it full circle to this evening, to Mr. Turner's work. I understand that you and Mr. Harper, and then of course Denise, had a bit of a conversation, and then poof, we have the Herschell Turner collection.
Karen Loomis is my creative partner in this. Denise is my assistant director for B. Luther. But Karen and I got together and she said, hey, I got this amazing exhibit that I want to bring to Sedona. I'm like, okay, well, what is it? And we started having this conversation. I was like, oh my gosh, this needs to be in Sedona. Sedona needs to see this amazing piece of art. It's extraordinary.
And then when you saw the images that came in when Karen was delivering them, was there a particular piece, or talk to us about your resonance with the collection?
When we started taking these pieces out and putting them on the wall, I mean, I physically got emotional, because when I saw Devil Angel, I consider that to be me anyway. She's just me and a little kid. If you knew who I was when I was a child, that would be it, you know? She's right there. It's such an amazing piece, but you look at the civil rights pieces and I choked up, because I looked at all that history and the things that our people have gone through, and here's this amazing artist that's depicting them in live and up front and personal, and you can't help but get emotional when you see it. It's just extraordinary art, and that's really, it's to honor him.
So with the Sedona Arts Academy, and we see that this collection's here, we see that you're having theatrical production. Can we know a bit more about the mindset that you have for the short-term future of offerings in the space here?
Yeah, I mean, we hope to offer theater, which is what we do. We hope to offer the art that's on the walls for the community to come and explore. There's meetings here. Russ does the conservatory, music and opera. We have Andrea, who sings. Winnie Munch does the Sedona Chamber Ballet. They're all partners here. And so we share in community, and we share in space, and we create in space. So it's real important that the community come out and support what we're doing here in the community, because this is what we realize that the community needs.
So is there a portal by which our viewers online and at home mm-hmm. can go to source? Is it the Sedona Arts Academy portal?
They can go to SedonaArtsAcademy.org and see what's happening during the week. We have classes here. We have paint and art. We have this meditation here. We have theater here. We have the gallery, so they can come in and they can see all that we have to offer. We got a foosball table in here. That's the best. come on.
So artists can come in and utilize it, for example, for dance instruction.
Yes.
So it's also a rentable space.
Yes, they can rent the space. I mean, it's a community center. And so we have a piano here. They can come and they can play the piano. They can play whatever. Just come and use the space, enjoy the space. It's economical, it's for everyone to use in the community. And we want people to come out and use it.
And is there a specific petition that you might make to the general public with regard to funding or help with the financial part of perpetuating the center?
Absolutely, we welcome the community to come and donate. We have Gigi Rock Productions, she does all of our events here at the Collective and for the Sedona Arts Academy. She is here tonight, so if you want to do an event, you can do that. You can do a fundraiser for us. That would be wonderful. You can contact Gigi for that, because she's really great at that. We've got some great stuff happening. We've got some great shows coming. But fundraising is key. We would love to have the community come out and support what we do. So donations are welcome.
So you're a formal 501c3 construct as well?
We have applied, absolutely. We have applied, and we're waiting for them to do their thing. But as of right now, you can still donate, and they'll honor that.
So support, right?
Absolutely.
Support the Academy.
Yes.
So are there questions for Camilla from the audience?
That's a good thing.
Fairy.
Yes. Just a sincere thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Harper was nice enough to give a sincere thank you from
thank
him.
Thank you so much.
For doing everything that she does in the community. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, please, a round of applause for our... So I think that's the wrap-up of our interview. I also wanted to check in with the young man who's back there in the back. Sir? Yes, if you could come up and share with us for just a moment.
This guy is so awesome. You know, Steve Bailey... He does my wine 101. We got a wine 101 class that we do here at the Sedona Arts Academy.
Is sort of like wine tastings?
Yeah, wine. He is the wine.
Wait, wine man. I need to know about that stat.
Come on, Steve. Come on up here, because we get our wine 101 on.
I'll let you.
No, you